Welcome to this Q&A of the day video in association with TLC Electrical Wholesaler, renowned for quality, value and customer service. Today's question relates to our series of videos on products from My Energy and is as follows. What is load curtailment as mentioned in regulation 722.311.201? Well, of course, this relates to electric vehicle charge points. Now, it's fair to say that if you install an EV charger and connect a car to it, then that is probably the single largest sustained load that you'll connect to a typical domestic property. A shower may draw more current, but for a much shorter period of time. So obviously, the installer needs to make sure that when they carry out their maximum demand calculations, they don't overload the supply. And if the maximum demand calculated is above 60 amps, then they must notify the local DNO before the installation starts. However, maximum demand is mentioned in regulation 722.311.201. In fact, it states that load curtailment, including load reduction or disconnection, either automatically or manually, may be taken into account when determining maximum demand of the installation or part thereof. So the question remains, what is load curtailment? Well, it's basically a way of monitoring how much current is flowing into either the EV charge point or an entire installation and setting a limit on that value so that the EV charger will not allow the charging vehicle to draw so much current that it overloads, and it does this by reducing the current flowing into the charging vehicle. How are manufacturers achieving this? Well, let's take My Energy as an example. Their Zappy 2 charger has built-in current monitoring technology so that it always knows how much current is being drawn by the charging vehicle. Now, this is extremely helpful because it can be used to set a cap on how much that individual device is drawing in terms of current. So let's say the Zappy 2 has been fitted to an existing 16 amp supply. You can set the load curtailment to make sure that the circuit doesn't get overloaded by the charging vehicle. What's even better though is that the Zappy 2 comes with a current transformer that clips around a conductor and measures how much current is flowing in that conductor. Now that can be applied in a couple of ways. It can connect around the main incoming line conductor and monitor how much the entire installation is drawing. Then if you set the Zappy 2 up with a load curtailment of say 60 amps, it will change the current flowing to the vehicle to make sure that the total installation current never exceeds the maximum value due to the car charging. This is what's required for load curtailment under Amendment 1. The current transformer can also be connected to a submain cable. So if you've got a charger in a garage on the end of an armoured cable and there's other appliances being fed from the same supply, you can achieve the same effect for the submain cable. Both scenarios allow you to take advantage of times when demand from the supply is low to maximise your charging capacity. So to summarise, load curtailment is a means of limiting the amount of current flowing into an installation or a load without tripping the circuit and disconnecting it from the supply. Thank you very much for watching.